is to Andhra Pradesh. Madam Speaker, the BJP, the YSRCP, the Congress, and now the Janasena party in Andhra Pradesh are saying that our CM has taken a U-turn and asking for SCS again instead of package, madam. Let me please go back to 2016. We are demanding for SCS till September 2016, madam. In September 2016, the Honorable Finance Minister made a statement that special package would be given, which would be equal in all respects to that of special category status. Since then, we were waiting for this package, madam. But even after presenting his final and full budget, FM did not give even a single penny under the package, madam. It is also not true when government of AP officials came to Delhi to discuss with the ministry, did the ministry not say that the government of India is not agreeable for 90-10 on externally aided projects, Mr. Finance Minister? Instead, they were told that central assistance will be provided by a way of repayment of loans for EAP projects in the ratio of 70-30, that too only till 2020, to the extent of 15,000 crores. And this too by putting the FRB under the state head, madam, and stressing out our borrowing capacity. See how many conditions you have put on EAP. And at a press conference on 7th March, the finance minister came with a 90-10 formula since he was cornered with facts and figures. I'm giving only one example due to paucity of time, madam. If this is how you deal with Andhra Pradesh, do you really think that people of AP would pardon you and have confidence in you and give you votes? You deceived us into accepting the special package by using the 14th Finance Commission as an excuse. You didn't even bother to give it legislative backing. To add injury to insult, we haven't received a single paisa promised in the package. Since nothing has been done so far on the special package, we are demanding to implement the cabinet decision on special category status to Andhra Pradesh, madam. So I wish to clarify the critics of our Chief Minister and the TDP that we're treading the right path. It is only you who are changing the goalposts for nefarious political gains. Madam, the Honourable Finance Minister said that industrial incentives given to other SCS states will no longer exist post the GST implementation, which is completely a misleading statement, madam. Even then, we insisted that whatever industrial incentives that these states get post the GST implementation should be given to AP as well on the lines of the assurances given by then Prime Minister. But what AP is given is 15% additional depreciation on new plant and machinery and 15% additional investment allowance. But they're given only to backward areas, not to the entire state. Secondly, it is not exclusively for 7 districts of AP alone, madam. It is for all the 150 backward districts in the entire country, and they're saying it's a special incentive for us, madam. What is special in this for Andhra Pradesh when 150 backward districts across the country are getting the same benefit? There's nothing special. Whereas even post-GST implementation, the SCS states continue to get industrial incentives in line with what they were getting earlier. As per the notification issued in July 2017, in pursuance of the budgetary support of 27,000 crores to the existing 4,324 units in SCS till sunset period of March 2027. And again, on 21st March 2018, the Ministry of Commerce and Industry approved the Northeast Industrial Development Scheme with a financial outlay of 3,000 crores to Northeast states up to March 2020. The incentives that are given are for capital investment, to access credit, interest incentive, GST reimbursement, IT reimbursement, transport, employment, and other incentives. But when we are asking to extend the same to us, the FM is silent. He's not saying anything about it. Here again, we have been misled, and therefore this promise remains unfulfilled. Speaker, madam, section 46(3) of the AP Reorganization Act talks about special development package for backward districts of Andhra Pradesh. This emanates from the assurances given by the Prime Minister, but this assurance has been diluted in the Act. The assurance was to provide package on the lines of KBK districts in Odisha and Bundelkhand in MP and UP. If you look at all the economic and human development indicators, it reveals that all seven backward districts in Andhra Pradesh are closer to SCS states rather than to other southern states, madam. But the Modi regime has given just 1,050 crores for seven districts over a three-year period. It is not in line with what has been given to KBK and Bundelkhand under special package. KBK was given 5,500 crores and Bundelkhand was given 7,200 crores each to UP and MP. And if you calculate per capita allocation, it's mind-boggling to tell you, madam. Madam, under the Bundelkhand package, the per head allocation of 4,115 per head was made, whereas for AP, the per head allocation is just 428 rupees, madam, one-tenth of what was given to the other regions, madam. So what has Government of India given to AP is a pittance, madam. Why are we being given just one-tenth of what was given in Bundelkhand on a per capita basis? Secondly, madam, BJP is crying foul that we have not spent even this small amount of money. Madam, we have spent 946 crores out of 1,050 crores, which is 92% of allocation, not 12% as claimed by them. We have UCs to prove that, madam, and we'll be happy to exhibit all of those. Madam, thirdly, the finance minister proposed additional 350 crores for the special package for these backward districts, and RBI released it and transferred it to the state account on 9th February 2008. But somehow the PMO has stopped giving clearance to it on 15th February 2018. So the funds have been taken out of our account and we've gone back to the Reserve Bank of India, madam. Now, Government of India has given Defense Industrial Corridor worth 20,000 crores for Bundelkhand, madam. But in the case of releasing a paltry 350 crores for our backward districts, the file is languishing in the PMO for the last 6 months, madam. Why this bias and partisan attitude, Mr. Prime Minister? Is this the way you want to help backward districts in AP? It's a shame. Therefore, this promise also remains unfulfilled. Madam, we are even deprived in distribution of assets. If you look at sections 50, 51, and 56, there's a huge discrepancy in right to recover tax arrears and sharing of liability or of refund of tax arrears. This has resulted in 3,820 crores lost to Andhra Pradesh, madam. There's a great delay in apportionment of institutions under Section 68 of the Act. And the AP Bhavan is yet to be divided between the two, madam. Madam, on revenue deficit, there's a dispute with regard to the quantum. Madam, I'm not yielding. I'm not yielding, madam.
Why are you putting a time limit on this?
Madam, I'm not yielding, madam.
Madam,
this is a no-confidence motion, madam.
Yes.
This is the initiation.
Madam,
yes.
There's a dispute with regard to the quantum of amount between the government of AP and the government of India. The revenue deficit for 10 months, that is from 2nd June 2014 to 31st March 2015, as per the government of AP, is 16,078 crores, madam. The government of India released 3,979 crores. Unilaterally taking standardized expenditure, Government of India qualified it as 4,117 crores, making the balance to be paid as 138 crores only. But the bone of contention is this, madam. Madam, the CAG put the figure at 16,078 crores and approved it also, madam. The Ministry of Finance made its own valuation and somehow put the figure at 7,500 crores without any justification. The PMO reduced it further to 4,117 crores, again, without any explanation, madam. So now the FM says he can only give 138 crores pending for us, whereas we're waiting for more than 12,000 crores to settle this account, madam. How is it justified? How is it justified? Secondly, as I said earlier, the Government of India has increased devolution of funds from 32% to 42%. But you also have to remember, there are cesses, such as the Krishi Kalyan cess, the Swachh cess, the higher education cess, and other cesses. If you look at how much Government of India collected through above cesses and other surcharges under direct and indirect taxes in 2016-17, it is quite mind-boggling, madam. Madam, 2.35 lakh crores has been collected under cesses, madam. But there is no share for states in these cesses, madam. So effectively, it is not 42%, but is somewhere closer to 36 or 37% of funds are actually going to states, madam. Madam, the BJP is saying that 22,113 crores have been given to AP alone as revenue deficit. It is wrong, madam. The 14th Finance Commission has also recommended revenue deficit of 4,519 crores to Kerala, 11,716 crores to West Bengal. They're all statutory allocations, madam. But the tragedy is that even after 5 years of award period of the 14th Finance Commission, AP is the only state which will remain revenue deficit, except for the 11 special category states, madam. So it's very clear where we belong financially, madam. So the BJP wanted to equate AP with the northeastern states, not willing it to bring it on par with the southern states. How is it justified, madam? Please tell us, how is it justified? Madam, the government of India says that 8,800 crores worth of EAP projects were approved for Andhra Pradesh. But the government of India has not issued any guidelines. When guidelines are not issued, nothing can be spent, madam. So government of AP is paying the interest of 5 crores on approved loans without guidelines having been framed, madam. The government of AP is asked for routing them through NABARD. But again, you are putting FRBM limits onto AP, madam. Finally, the finance ministry agreed that they could not issue guidelines for EAP projects, madam. So we have asked for NABARD, madam. Then they said to set up an SPV, madam. Whether there's any history in the country where an SPV has been set up for EAPs, we are not aware, madam. We cannot find any such reference. To route funds through SPV and FRBM also will be borne by the state, madam, which further burdens our financial capabilities. So it's totally a delay tactics by the finance minister, madam. Sorry, madam. Madam, facts and figures are very hard to remember, sir, so we definitely do need to use papers. On 13,742 crores given to Andhra Pradesh, madam, the Honorable Finance Minister and the President of AP BJP unit have been trumpeting through press conferences that they have given 13,472 crores to Andhra Pradesh. And they have also said that they have never given such huge amount to any other state. Let me explain in a minute what they have given and under which head they've given it, madam. Madam, they are saying that they've given 13,472 crores. But actually, out of 16,000 crores revenue deficit, they've given 3,900 crores, madam. For Polavaram, project cost is 58,000 crores, but they've given 6,764 crores, madam. They've given 576 crores for 11 institutions where the required amount is 11,672 crores. For the new capital, we need 43,000 crores, but we've been given only 1,550 crores, madam. We should get 23,000 crores for the backward districts if you look at Bundelkhand package, madam, but you've given us just 1,050 crores. So the government of AP is asking for 1.54 lakh crores, whereas you've given just 13,472 crores, madam. The government is saying that it is fulfilling all the promises. All the promises. Madam, giving 2 to 3% of the required funds, is that fulfillment? I ask you, madam, is it fulfillment? 2 to 3% of the requirement is not a fulfillment, madam. It's a shame to call it that they're all being fulfilled. Now, let me come under which head and section you've given us the money. Madam, the revenue deficit has been given to us as mandated under Section 46(2) of the AP Reorganization Act. Money has been given for Polavaram as mandated under Section 90 of the AP Reorganization Act. Money has been given for institutions under Section 93 and Schedule 13 of the AP Reorganization Act. Money has been given for new capital as directed under Section 94(3) of the AP Reorganization Act. Money has been given for backward districts as directed under Section 46(3) of the AP Reorganization Act. Madam Speaker, they are saying that they have given 13,472 crores. I agree. But they've given it under compulsion, as mandated by the AP Reorganization Act. So to say that they have given this money to AP without mandate is a ridiculous comment. They have given because they are mandated to give it, but it is riddled with deceit and woefully short of being adequate. It certainly builds no confidence and no trust. Madam Speaker, Section 94(3) says that the financial support for creation of essential facilities in the new capital of AP would be provided by the Government of India. The estimates were made. Madam, 43,000 crores is required over a period of 5 years to construct essential infrastructure in Amaravati. But Government of India has given just 1,500 crores and now screaming instead of releasing more money that Government of AP has not submitted UCs in spite of submitting the same. Madam, out of 1,500 crores given by Government of India, we have submitted UCs for more than that, madam. We've spent 1,583 crores, madam. 3,500 crores is the cost for the Sardar Vallabhai Patel statue in Gujarat, madam. 3,000 crores is the cost for Chhatrapati Shivaji statue in Maharashtra, madam. But you've given us 1,500 crores for to build an entire capital, madam. I'm not saying you shouldn't give that money, fine, whether the sources are from the government or from somewhere else. But the fact is, statues are getting more funding than entire capital city of Andhra Pradesh, madam. Madam, the PM is constructing Dholera city in Gujarat, madam. It is 80 kilometers away from Ahmedabad. Dholera would be twice the size of Delhi, which took 1,000 years to grow to what it is now. Dholera is proposed to be 6 times bigger than Shanghai. Is it wrong for the enterprising people of Andhra Pradesh to dream of having a world-class capital, madam?
Yes, please answer that.
Secondly, the Prime Minister is on record saying that if voted to power, he would build us a capital bigger and better than Delhi itself, madam. He said that in front of Lord Balaji, madam. He himself advised our CM to visit Astana, the capital of Kazakhstan, madam. Is it not true, Mr. Prime Minister? Madam, I wish to bring to your notice and to the notice of the House that an amount of $68 billion has been spent on building the capital of Kazakhstan in Astana, madam. How can Amaravati be built with 1,500 crore rupees, madam? Thirdly, the government of AP pooled 33,000 acres of land through the pooling method, which is one of its kind in India, the value of which is more than 50,000 crores, madam. More than 30,000 farmers have given up their land, madam. Yes. And they are counting on our government and the government of India to take care of the investment that they've made by giving us that land and protecting their lives and protecting their future. The 30,000 farmers are at risk, not only here, but all the projects where land has been taken, madam. They're all suffering because of lack of funding, madam.
Yes.
Madam,
now your half an hour is also completed.
Madam,
now within
madam,
5 minutes.
Madam, no, madam, I didn't start.
I'm sorry.
Madam, we didn't start until 11:15, madam.
I have given
we
you
didn't
that
start
time.
At 11 o'clock, madam.
Yes, please.
We didn't start at 11 o'clock, madam.
Please,
it's
please.
Only 12 o'clock now.
Please listen to me. You ask me more half an hour. I have already given you. Now you wrap up. Yes.
Madam,
yes.
Just 10 minutes, madam. Thirdly, the government of AP pulled for Navi Mumbai, they are giving 48,000 acres to ease the pressure on Mumbai, madam. Now the opposition parties are criticizing, why should you have 33,000 acres? But the moot point is, what are you doing to those farmers who have sacrificed their land for the capital, madam? Madam, Amaravati has been given 2,500 crores, but out of this, 1,000 crores was given to Vijayawada and Guntur for underground drainage systems, madam. When underground drainage in my city of Guntur itself cost 1,000 crores in a small town like Guntur, can we build a world-class capital for 1,500 crores, madam? It's ridiculous. Madam, for drainage, 32% work has been completed and UCs have been submitted for 32% of the work for the UGD, madam. Madam, it's okay. These are all the copies of the UCs, madam. We'll be happy to submit them to whoever wants to take a look at them. Madam, it is 4 years' work. In 1.5 years, we've completed 32%. We've submitted UCs for works to the tune of 330 crores. This is for the UGD in Guntur, madam. The BJP is saying that only 8% has been spent. It is wrong. This can be checked through the public finance management online software in the finance ministry. It is there for all to see, madam. Even for backward districts, out of 1,050 crores, we have spent so far 946 crores and submitted UCs. Moreover, AP is listed as the third best state in the country for submitting UCs, madam. Sir, madam, we have spent 92% funds. BJP says that only 12% funds have been spent so far. It is wrong, madam. Raising the bogey of UCs and suspecting and unnecessarily tarnishing the image of our CM is not acceptable, madam. Recently, 350 crores have been recommended afresh by the Finance Ministry, and the RBI released it on February 9th, 2018. But the PMO stopped giving clearance on 15th February, so the funds have gone back to the RBI, madam. As I said earlier, through the AP reorganization bill, both the national parties have played havoc with its provisions and its wording, madam. This was the strategy of the Congress to leave room in the wording to legally back out of the commitments at a later date. And BJP, instead of opposing this, supported these words when the bill was passed. And now the BJP is using these flexibilities to claim that they are doing everything legally required. And I'm sure this term will come up again and again in their speeches. They're doing everything legally required, as in the case of railway zone, steel plant, and metro, which will never see the light of day. The Act uses the ambiguous terms interspersed with words like examine, feasibility, provisional estimate, deliberately to have an escape route without binding them to fulfill the commitments and assurances of the Act. We demand that the provisions of the AP Reorganization Act should be fulfilled in letter and spirit, madam, without taking shelter under these ambiguous words. The point I'm trying to drive is whatever has been given as mandated by the AP Reorganization Act or as per the award of the 14th Finance Commission, which has also been given to other states. So there is nothing special or exclusively given for AP. In the last budget, madam, I made a comment. Specifically for AP, we received 1,800 crores, which is less than the collections of the Bahubali cinema that is famous in India, madam. So it is not charity, madam. It's mandatory. You have not shown any magnanimity or showered your blessings on us in the form of additional allocations. It is the mandate given to you by the Act and the Commission. Any government at the center has to do it. And you have not given a single penny as part of any of the assurances given by then Prime Minister Manmohan Singh on the floor of Rajya Sabha, madam. This is what the people of AP are demanding. While we are asking to implement the assurances, the FM and Mr. Hari Babu, former head of AP BJP, are telling what they have given under AP Reorganization Act.
Nobody's name will be taken like this.
About assurances, they're talking about AP Reorganization Act, madam. When we talk about meager allocations given under base provisions of AP Reorganization Act, they say that thousands of crores are proposed under various projects. Madam, if we ask one thing, they reply another thing, madam. This spit and run won't work anymore, madam. We are not asking them to deposit 15 lakhs in the bank account of every citizen in Andhra Pradesh, madam. We're only demanding our rights, madam.
Okay.
Madam, let me skip to the. I'll just come, madam.
Yeah.
Madam, the infrastructure points I'm skipping, Mr. Ramohan will take them up. Let me get to the escalation process we followed, madam. I'll just concluding in a little bit. TDP waited for 4 long years and 5 budgets of the central government. No justice has been done to the state of Andhra Pradesh, madam. We have been requesting, forcefully requesting, demanding, protesting, and finally threatening and walking out of the government and the NDA, where our 2 ministers resigned from the cabinet, madam. In order to bring it to the attention of the parliament, which decided the fate of Andhra Pradesh in 2014 by bifurcating the state unscientifically and in an undemocratic manner as a last resort. We decided to disrupt parliament, which is a part of the democratic process. A weapon, I'm not saying anything, nothing undemocratic. It is undemocratic.
Please,
lights
please.
Are closed, the doors are locked, the cameras are shut off. What do you call it? You
call it
we are not opposing
this
the
bifurcation.
We are saying
process.
How it was done. How it was done, we are
now
commenting
conclude.
On that. How it was done, we are commenting
Madam,
on that. We are facing problems because of that.
It is done in the most undemocratic manner.
We have to stand
just
with us.
Singh.
We have to stand with
no,
us.
No, he is not completing. It's
we
okay.
We have to stand with us.
I will take.
We are facing the problems.
Complete your thing. Jaydev Galla ji, complete it now.
Madam,
I have taken the name.
Madam,
yes.
These decisions were not taken in a hurry, madam.
Yes.
Madam,
now conclude. That's all. Thanks
madam,
to the chair. Yes.
While we have been escalating.
Yeah, that's okay. Yes. Now conclude. Yes.
The 14th Finance Commission is taken as a shield
okay.
for not giving STS.
Okay.
GST is taken as a shield for not giving industrial
okay.
incentives.
Okay.
Party funding
yes.
will take. Poultry funding will take 20 to 30 years for completing the institutions.
Yes, yes, yes.
The Modi regime has been saying that they are still evaluating the railway zone, studying feasibility of the integrated steel
yes.
plant at Kadapa, apart from other
okay.
issues. While we are protesting the government to deliver their promises,
okay.
the BJP
yes.
has been delaying, misleading, colluding with our rival parties in Andhra Pradesh, and it has encouraged them to attack the TDP, madam. Madam,
thank
while
you.
TDP
thank
MPs
you.
Are on the watch list,
thank
the
you.
YSRC Lakit MPs
Singh
are on the guest list of the Prime Minister
okay.
and
now
Amit Shah, madam.
Singh. It's okay now. You are completed.
Madam,
now, thank you.
Madam,
thank you very much. No, no, now I have taken the name of Rakesh Singh. It's okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Rakesh Singh.
Yes, Rakesh Singh.
धन्यवाद अध्यक्ष महोदय.
Okay. आप बोलो ना बाद में जब बोलोगे जब नो 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 यस नो नो नॉट लाइक दिस नो ही इज नॉट कंक्लूडिंग व्हाट कैन आई डू
धन्यवाद अध्यक्ष महोदय
ओनली वन सेंटेंस दैट्स ऑल ओनली वन सेंटेंस ऑफ कंक्लूड नो आई एम सॉरी आई विल अलाउ यू ऑल्सो आफ्टरवर्ड्स बट नॉट लाइक
ओके मैडम
यस नाउ कंक्लूड ओनली से थैंक यू चेयर
आई एम कंक्लूडिंग Madam, just one minute, madam.
No, no.
One minute. I'll
no,
finish it.
No, half a minute.
Madam, 1 minute to conclude, madam.
Yes.
Madam, from the state of AP, we have become the residual state
okay.
of AP. We're not asking to turn the clock back. We're not asking to turn the clock back. We're only asking you to do justice to Andhra Pradesh.
Yes, yes, thank you.
Madam, in conclusion, madam, it is quite relevant and necessary to quote what Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel had said, madam. Sir, will you let
yes,
me do
please,
the conclusion?
Please, please.
To quote Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, madam, it will be a folly to ignore realities. Facts take their own revenge if they're not faced squarely and well. This quote exactly suits Andhra Pradesh, madam.
Thank you, thank
And I'm
you.
Sure that the Prime Minister, the President of the BJP and the Finance Minister, we realize that it will be folly to ignore realities
thank you.
And
That's
because
all.
Facts and
That's
truth
all.
Will take
Jitendra
their revenge.
Jitendra Reddy ji,
Hence,
I will
I demand
look
the Prime Minister to at least
if
give a hand-holding to such a defective state of AP by conferring special category.
This video meeku nachinatlayite like chesi mee friends tho share cheyandi. Marini interesting videos koraku maa channel ni subscribe cheskondi.